Hey there, Max here from maxharland.com. I'm an emotional health coach, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you 5 stress management techniques to help you reduce stress from too much screen time. Whether it's because you're working remotely or you're going to online school or just Zoom calls with your grandparents, most of us are spending way too much time on our screens these days, and it's stressing us all out. This is going to be the first in a series of videos that are going to teach you simple, free, and time-effective stress management techniques. So if you're interested in that, you can see the whole playlist down in the show notes. Before we dive in, if you haven't already, I want to give you my free stress management video course. It's 3 videos over 3 days delivered straight to your inbox. It's 10 minutes each, so you can sneak it in on like a lunch break or a bathroom break. And I think it's super effective. It'll help you reduce your stress drastically. And you can get it by going to maxharland.com/stressless. And I'll link that in the show notes down below too, because, you know, who wants to type that in? So staring at screens too much has a couple really big health issues associated with it. You know, the obvious one is eye strain. Looking at monitors too long damages our eyes, and that's stressful emotionally. You know, if you're going blind, that's stressful. The second one is it reduces our breathing and it depresses us physically. Usually when we're staring at screens, we're slouched over, and it's hard to breathe deep and relax when you're slouched over. Additionally, staring at screens often means that we're comparing ourselves to other people socially, and we're consuming super stressful news about how the world is, you know, burning. And that's inherently insanely stressful. And last and definitely not least is too much screen time means too much blue light coming in the eyes, and too much blue light means that our body can't produce melatonin, we can't get deep restful sleep, and that creates more stress as well, and it's a vicious, vicious feedback loop. So what do you do about it? I've got 5 simple techniques, and here's the first one. The first one is really simple, hardcore discipline, no screens, 1 hour before bed. That's gonna let you get that nice melatonin surge that does happen when you don't have artificial light coming into your body. That's gonna help with sleep. The second tip is directly related to the first one, and it's more of like an overall lifestyle thing, and it starts earlier in the day. And that is, get the blue light off your devices starting in the early afternoon. There's apps that can do this. I know that the iPhone has a native software to do this. And I know that Android has an app you can install. And there's also an app for desktop and laptops. But all these apps take your screen, and as the evening approaches, it makes your screen go from blue to orange. And that helps you produce that melatonin and rest. So this means even if you are watching screen time a little bit too late, it's not gonna mess up your sleep as bad as it would have if you didn't have these apps installed. And I will link to the app for your desktop down in the show notes, but it's called Flux, F.LUX. The third thing you can do to reduce the emotional stress and the damage of too much screen time is movement. So another big issue is when we're using screens, we don't move enough. So if you're able to, make yourself a stand-up workstation, either at home or at the office. And it doesn't have to be fancy. It can literally be a cardboard box or a stack of books. But make yourself a stand-up workstation if you can. If you can't, do the next best thing. Set a timer on your phone every hour on the hour, and make sure that you stand up and move for at least 5 minutes. You know, go on a short walk, go sprint up the stairs, go stretch. Just make sure that you don't have long stretches of like 6 hours where you don't stand up. The fourth technique to help you reduce the stress from too much screen time is to go on a social media and news fast. Even if it's just for a day or two, stop consuming as much social media and as much news. You'll be shocked at how little stuff is actually important that's happening, and how easy it is to stay current with current events if you ask one or two friends, hey, what's going on in the world? The big issue here is social media leads to us comparing ourselves to other people, and it makes us miserable because no matter how cool your life is, it's not going to be as cool as your friend's social media life. It's curated, it's designed to look good, and it's always going to be better than reality. And the news cycle is an engine designed to pump out as much emotionally stressful, painful news as possible, because anxiety, anger, these things spread faster than good, positive emotions. So news companies profit off of sharing bad emotion. And my fifth and final tip to reduce the stress from too much screen time is what's called the 20-20-20 rule. This is a rule designed to help you protect your eyes, and it's essentially every 20 minutes, look up, stare at something 20 feet away, and focus on it for 20 seconds. having your eyes learn how to focus in close, like on a laptop, and then focus farther away so that they learn different focal distances, means that the muscles in your eyes stay strong. This will help you not get nearsighted as fast. It'll help you avoid the painful eye strain. And as a result of those things, it will hopefully lead to less emotional stress. You know, if your eyes are strained and you have a blistering headache and you're gradually going nearsighted from too many hours at the office, you're gonna be pretty stressed and miserable. So let's avoid that, practice the 20-20-20 rule. Hey, I hope this was super useful for you. I hope that you found these 5 quick tips effective in helping to reduce stress from too much screen time. If you haven't already, please do go check out my free 3-day stress management video course, which is linked down in the show notes below. You know, each one of these videos is 10 minutes long, they're super effective, and you know, they're free, so I'll give you your money back if you hate them. If you have any questions or comments about either these techniques or stress management in general, leave them down in the comments below. I'm gonna get to every comment for at least the first month, and I'll try and get to these comments as much as I can possibly get to them. In the next video in this series, I'm going to share with you why online schooling and why working from home is so much more stressful than going to the school or going to the office, and also what you can do about it. So if you're interested in that, you can see the entire playlist linked down below as well. See you in the next video.